let me show you how to create a podcast episode on an iPad. The first thing I do is I have a plan. I make sure I know what I'm going to say and how it's going to flow throughout the episode. Secondly, I get an external microphone, and that would allow me to get a microphone a little bit closer to my mouth, unlike just the microphones that are built into the iPad. There's stand mics that you could use that are great. However, you might not have one of those around, so you could just use the earbuds or ear pods that you have that would allow you to have a microphone a little bit closer to your mouth. All right, let's get started. The first thing we want to do is open GarageBand. Then tap the Add Song button or the plus sign. Select Audio Recorder and then Voice. Under the Studio view, change the sound from lead vocals to narrator. Right under the control bar, hit the plus sign. Song sections. Then change it from 8 bars to automatic. Tap off the menu. In the control bar, tap the wrench, tap metronome, and count in. Change it to no sound and tap off the menu. On the left side is the input level. You can adjust it and watch the meter. You want to make sure the meter shows as much green as possible when talking. If you have headphones on, you can monitor it with this right side and change the volume as needed. The recording sign is under the control bar. When you press record, the ruler becomes red and moves. Touch the stop button when you're done recording that track. Now let's take a look at that track. On the control bar, touch Tracks View. Press play to preview and move the playhead around. All right, let's add another track. Let's hit the plus sign under the tracks. Again, we have many options, but let's choose voice again. And also, make sure you check the settings from before. Then you can record your second track. You can move regions around by selecting them and moving them with one finger. While editing, you can pinch open and close to zoom in and out. To see more options for each region, double tap. In this case, we're going to split it in half. So we're going to tap split and then swipe down to actually split. You will also notice the yellow bars at the end of each region. You can slide those in to trim the ends of each of those recordings. All right, now that we have all of our speaking tracks, let's add some music. You can add loops from Apple or other audio files on your iPad. First, let's create another track. Choose the loops icon on the control bar, select audio files, and drag the music track you want to use in. If you want to bring the file into GarageBand, import the track from the Browse Items from the Files app button. You will just need to make sure you could access that file from the Files app. Let's create a bumper track that plays music and then slowly lowers its volume. Swipe over to see the track headers, which includes the track icon, channel volume and meter, and also the solo and mute buttons. Tap the icon again, select automation. Slide the pencil over until it is red at the top left part of the control bar. Click on the timeline to create automation points. Drag each point up and down and over to do slight raises and decreases in the volume. When you're done, slide the pencil back over to lock your automation points and then done on the top right of your control bar. Make sure you listen to your entire episode to make sure you don't need to fix anything else. Sharing. Tap My Songs to go back home. That's called the My Songs browser. Tap and hold the recording you just made. Here you can rename the project and share the song or the whole project. Choose song if you want people to just hear your creation. Select an audio quality. Medium will likely work for your purposes. Also, change the artist info as well. Select Share. Now we need to decide what to do with the episode we just made. We might just want to store it for later and put it in Buckeye Box. This will require you to have the Box app installed on your iPad, and you will need to be signed in. We can also turn it into Karma Canvas as an assignment. This will require you to have the Canvas app installed on your iPad, and you will need to be signed in. You also might want to broadcast your podcast to the entire world with Apple Podcasts and other podcast distributors. This will require you to download an app like Anchor and create a third-party account. It's always a good idea to be comfortable with the terms and conditions when signing up for an account that isn't supported by us. You will also need to be signed into Anchor on your iPad. Here's how you share your podcast. To send it to Buckeye Box, choose Copy to Box, and then choose where you want to put it in the box. To send it to Karma Canvas, choose Copy to Student. This sends your audio file to Canvas so that you can turn it in for an assignment. To send it to Anchor, choose Copy to Anchor. This puts it in your Anchor library so you could drag the file over to make a new podcast. There you go. Those are the basics of creating a podcast episode on your iPad. Remember, play and practice are the best way to get better at something, and your podcast will keep improving as you make them. Now go explore and tell some great stories.